To ask me if I could break a $100 bill, and I couldn't. I had $40 on them, and I said, "I'll gladly give you this $40." So, it just seemed a little bit quiet. Not there's no energy. It's just sort of I guess tired but bored. And he said he's going to get something to eat. And at that time, I used to run, you know, at least 10 miles a day, played basketball. I was a nut and I had eaten, and I invited myself to say, "Oh my God, I'm starving. Can I go?" And Scott, I'll tell you, it was 10-second pause. And I mentioned this. It's like in my head, I'm going, I overstepped my boundaries. I just invited myself with OJ Simpson to get something to eat. And then he paused and said, "Sure." But it was one of those sures that was really like, "No, don't come."
Right.
But anyways, I go with him. I have no idea where we're going. You know, it's up to this. And he's driving around, and that's where he drove to a McDonald's. Mm-hmm. And I don't even eat McDonald's. So he drove there, and I looked for the healthiest thing on the menu, and I got a chicken sandwich. And he got, I think, 2 quarter pounders, and he ate them in 30 seconds. And wow. I didn't eat in the car at all, because I thought we were going to eat together in his house. So when he dropped us off, I walked to his door, like the kitchen, and he was still at his car at the door. And I looked and I was like, "I'll go to my room."
Right.
Because it looked like I already invited myself. Now I'm going to think that I'm going to eat with him. And that was the last I saw. And then everything else is timeline in the murder.
Wow.
Yeah. In hindsight, it's the difficult part is I explained to Kim Goldman, I became friends. And I told her, I feel so horrible about if it screwed up the whole timeline of me inviting, maybe his plan was, I don't know, to go early or whatever. And she says, "You can't think like that." And I just felt like my timeline made it with that, the timing for Ron to go there. And it was just an awful feeling I've had forever. And she just said, "No, that is," you know, basically she just said, "No, it had nothing to do with you."
Yeah. And I want to say this too, when they see this, the Goldmans, Nicole Brown's family, they're not the enemy, because, you know, this trial had a separation at one point, black versus white, for OJ, not for OJ. He did it, he didn't do it. And that lasted for years. So I just want to put that out there, man. We are like still to this day heartbroken that they had to deal with that, because, I mean, it's a lot of crime for where I come from and things that still happen to this day. You don't want to lose a child. It's not cool.
Everybody lost the focus of two young people losing their lives. It's because the media divided cameras up with black and white, and they seemed like they wanted to start friction. And it was an awful thing. Everybody lost focus of Nicole and Ron.
Right.
And it just became a different focus. And it was just a horrible thing of how powerful the media is, and how they can sway people and get arguments and make love and hate.
Right. Yeah. And watching that, you know, it was very heartbreaking to watch them break down and to see a father, you know, yearning for his son and not having a son here, because I learned that Ron Goldman was going to open up a restaurant, and just coincidentally, the name of it was Life After Eternal Life or something like that. The emblem that he was going to have on the door. Right.
I didn't know that story, but what a story.
Yeah, it was going to be just he wasn't going to have a name on it. It was just going to be a label, a logo with no name, and the logo meant eternal life.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow, that's an amazing story. Yeah. And I had done Kim's podcast. She didn't mention that, but the families involved, the thing that really stands out, I think, is how much they love their kids.
Right.
It was all about, you know, it's devastating of how they, you know, that's it, nobody wants, no parent wants to outlive their children. Right. And the pain's so evident. But
right.
Yeah, and then, and you know, and then I, so what I've always said is, I've said this so many times on shows, and I say it because I think you're the kind of person that would really appreciate it. I look at life kind of like a semester at college because it's so fast. It goes by. I mean, you're talking to me, it's already 29 years, and you said you're in a 10, and now you're, you know, it's, it just goes by.
It does.
So I always tell my wife this, I go, life is so short. We got to have fun. And because before you know it, it's over.